I like that look on your face, Mobius. You really don't know what to do now, do you, old man? Here you are, caught without your damn staff. And I suspect things aren't progressing quite as you'd hoped. You're not used to the fly turning to confront you in your web, are you?
Kane's devious influence has poisoned your mind, Raziel. Now you see betrayal everywhere, even in your closest allies.
We were never allies, Mobius. Conspirators, perhaps. Briefly.
Why did you not kill Cain when you had the chance? He was at your mercy.
Precisely. I had a choice, and I chose mercy. And now I know your sordid little secret. The significance of that displacement I felt when the two Reavers came together. Strangely enough, I was enlightened by the devious Cain, not by you. In fact, I've learned much more than you counted on. I understand now how you've tried to manipulate all of history for your own personal gain. But now all your little schemes are whirling in ruin around you, aren't they? All because I chose to exert my will for once, rather than obey the demands of sorcerers and spirits and demons all singing the same tiresome refrain, "Kill Cain!" I'm setting my own path from here, Mobius. I intend to discover the truth behind all of this.
But you condemn us all with this impetuous act.
Hardly impetuous. It took all the will I could muster. Has my refusal to kill Cain reshuffled your carefully stacked deck of cards?
You really think that you're exercising your free will, Raziel? You're simply Cain's servant.
I do not serve Cain. I merely did not kill him.
Raziel, do not forget your purpose here. You are destined to be the savior of Nosgoth.
Oh, I'm sick of hearing that particular phrase. As for saving Nosgoth, so far I see precious little reason to bother. And I'll choose my own purpose from here on out, Time Streamer. Right now, I choose to manipulate you for a change. Go. In there.
What are you doing?
Come now, Mobius. You're a cunning serpent. You'll piece it together, I imagine. This era is of no further use to me. You will operate this device to provide me passage. I want to see the world in a simpler time, before the Sarafan began their crusade.
And what about Cain? You're leaving your quarry behind.
You kill him if it's so damned important.
You need only touch the two poles of the switch, and the device will transport you. But I urge you to reconsider.
You've lost your powers of persuasion, old man. Rot here and forget me. Even as I emerged from that infernal time-streaming chamber, I suspected treachery. The stronghold was vacant, derelict, abandoned. Thank you. Any doubts about the era I now occupied, this grotesque tableau certainly eliminated them. For here was Mobius, long since murdered by Cain, lionized and beatified as the martyred leader of his bloodthirsty crusade. And if I required further evidence, I needed only to behold the gruesome trophy Mobius held aloft, a severed head of Vorador. The final triumphant kill of Mobius's cutthroat mob. His execution marked the annihilation of the vampires. Far from channeling me into Nosgoth's past, Mobius had propelled me over a century to its ghastly future. The intent behind this little detour was unmistakable. Having failed to make me his obedient assassin, Mobius intended to keep me ignorant of my true destiny, which clearly lay in Nosgoth's past. While his deception only reinforced my purpose, Mobius had effectively stranded me here. This left me no course but to explore the era I now occupied and see what changes the century had wrought following Cain's ill-fated decision. Perhaps time had cleared a path for me into the mountains, where I might unearth more clues behind the mystery of Janos Ordrin.
No charade, Raziel. Only the entreaties of this martyred spirit.
Your pleas mean nothing to me after all your deceit. You have propelled me into Nosgoth's future, Mobius, and left me stranded here.
I am truly sorry, Raziel, but it was necessary. Consider it the last valiant act of a doomed man. You have strayed from your purpose, and now behold the result. Gaze upon the wasteland you and Cain offered together.
I fail to see how I'm responsible.
You spared Cain, and by doing so, you have released a multitude of horrors upon this world. I can accept that Cain has murdered me, has he? As the Time Guardian, I foresaw that incident long before it occurred. And I take some small comfort in the fact that Cain remains the sole survivor of his vile breed. But you have single-handedly made my sacrifice meaningless.
Your argument is disingenuous, Time Streamer. I cannot see how killing or sparing Cain's future self would alter these events. This wasteland was created by Cain's original refusal at the Pillars. And amidst all these twists and turns, that event has never changed. You are coming with this. I think you've gotten tangled in your own way.
As Cain clings to his precious seat of power, the Pillars sink into a mire of decay, dragging all of Nosgoth down with them.
I don't think this has anything to do with the Pillars, or Cain's failure to sacrifice himself. I think you're simply afraid, because you don't know what he's up to. He's a wild card, isn't he? And you don't want his influence in your game. Which is why you wanted me to eliminate him. Well, now that he survived, you have no idea what's coming, do you? Maybe, for the first time in your entire life, you're terrified that he may have truly found a third option out of the dilemma you orchestrated for him.
Cain's lies have addled your mind. Leave this place and trouble my spirit no more.
If you even are a spirit, you've forgotten. I have a way to tell for sure. If you're willing to risk it. Think so. Either way, you lose. Thank you. These were the pillars so familiar to my blighted eyes. But now that I had begun to learn their true significance, I regarded the pillar's destruction with a new, enlightened sense of horror. And I questioned now whether Cain's simple refusal, his mere ambition, could truly have caused such devastation. I felt that some darker influence was at work here. As I approached, I discerned the spirit of Ariel, bound here now for more than a century.
Forever am I bound, hope abandoned, my spirit tethered to this place. What destroyed the circle could not touch me, for I was newly dead and beyond harm's reach. I alone was spared the descent into madness, and Cain alone was spared the pain of death. When the Praptor's poison seized Cain even in the safety of the womb, much more than just his destiny was lost. All of Nosgoth lost balance. Consider us now, both of us less than we once were. I, pure but insubstantial, and Cain, terribly real, but corrupted.
Your imprisonment here has deranged you, spirit. You fixate on Cain because you believe he is the tether that binds you here. You both know he is not the author of your agony. The pillars were subverted by dark forces, invited by the Guardians themselves. The more I learn of your circle, the more I see a tangle of nested manipulations.
Cain handed them their victory. They sought to topple the pillars, and he was their willing instrument.
Or was he their unwilling pawn? Would it blunt your wrath to know that Cain's dilemma was calculated to bring the pillars down, regardless of the choice he made, and that the devastation would have been even greater had he chosen the path you would prescribe for him?
You are a subtle, deceitful creature. But your clever arguments do not absolve Cain. He must die for the pillars to be restored. There is no other way.
Then consider this more ominous possibility. What if Cain's death does not restore the pillars? Consider that it may simply be too late, that this world may be beyond redemption, and that you may be bound here eternally.
Hound me, demon. You can see that I am captive here. Show me some mercy.
Like the mercy you showed your fellow guardians when you set Cain on them? Or the mercy you showed Cain when you kept him ignorant of his destiny while you used him as the scourge of the circle? Or perhaps like the mercy you showed your beloved Napraptor when you made him Cain's first kill?
You are cruel. Why do you torment me?
I'm merely looking for answers, Ariel. Very well. I'll leave you in peace. But know this about you and this purgatory from which you long to escape. You're merely at the threshold.
Thank you. Thank you. Raziel, the failed assassin. You had Cain at your mercy, but lacked the courage to fulfill the act. And now you see the wasteland wrought by the tyrant's hand, by his selfish decision to preserve his own life, even when it meant sacrificing the whole world. This is the fate of Nosgoth, as long as Cain remains alive.
An ironic condemnation, given this guilty scene. One would think you'd torn down the pillars single-handedly. What are you trying to obliterate as you drag your loathsome body through this chamber? And why, as Nosgoth descends into madness and misery, do you appear to thrive? Things in this world, I am learning, are rarely what they seem. You, apparently, are no exception.
I am the engine of life, the source of Nosgoth's very existence. I am the hub of the wheel, the origin of all life, the devourer of death.
Or maybe you're just hungry. Could it be as simple as that? Wouldn't that be poetic irony? The great adversary of the vampires turns out to be the biggest parasite of them all.
Do not test my patience, Raziel. I made you, and I will unmake you if I become so inclined.
As your agent, I am beyond death.
There are fates worse than death, Raziel.
Oh, I see you now as you truly are. A cancer, a spooling parasite burrowed deep in the heart of this world.
Go now. Play out your pitiful rebellion and take your place among the destroyed, the used, and the damned. But know this, you are mine for eternity. You have always been, and will always be, my soul reaver.
Thank you. Thank you.
Beyond this edifice lay my sole hope of escaping this demon-infested wasteland. The time-streaming device contained therein offered my only prospect of journeying back into Nosgoth's early history. Unless I discovered some means of breaking the seal, I was condemned to be stranded here eternally. Thank you.